In May 2020, 37 acts were performed remotely and compiled into a special live event known as the Quarantine Cabaret. And now, June 2020, 31 more acts join the fray. Live from everyone's own living spaces, it is the Quarantine Cabaret Strikes Back. This time, it's personal. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here he is once again, your host, all the way from Boston, Massachusetts, Zach Swasta.
Greetings, everyone. Welcome back, all of you. Welcome back. And welcome, once again, to the Quarantine Cabaret Strikes Back. This time, it's personal. And we are going to... I'm sorry, I kind of lost my train of thought there. Can we try that introduction again? Yeah, thank you.
Here he is, once again, your host, Zach Swasta!
Greetings, everyone! Yeah, let's keep that applause going. Keep the same energy, same vibes everywhere. And so we've got a lot of great talent for y'all, and that's all, folks.
Here he is once again, Zach Swasta!
Salutations, Zach! Salutations? Who says that? One more time, okay? Okay.
Here he is once again, Zach Swasta!
You know what, let's just go on with it. Let's just go. Alright, well anyway, so glad to be doing this again. We had a fun time last month doing that first cabaret. A lot of good entries, and guess what? We got plenty more going on this time around. So, without further ado, let's get this show on the road. Let's start off the right way with some words of wisdom from a reading from our friend from Delaware, Miss Shylah Davies.
When This Is Over by Laura Kelly Fanucci. When this is over, may we never again take for granted a handshake with a stranger, full shelves at the store, conversations with neighbors, a crowded theater, Friday night out, the taste of communion, a routine checkup, the school rush each morning, coffee with friends, the stadium's roaring, each deep breath, a boring Tuesday, life itself. When this ends, may we find that we have become more like the people we wanted to be, we were called to be, and we hope to be. And may we stay that way, better for each other, because of the worst. Stay safe, stay home, stay strong.
Well said, Shylah. Well said. So for those of you who remember, we broadcast the first Quarantine Cabaret back in May. First it was just the acts as they were, one after another. Then we did it again the day after with yours truly as the host. And then shortly thereafter we put it on YouTube for permanent safekeeping. As many of you would know, we are not the only ones to have done a Quarantine Cabaret. In fact, many people on YouTube have been doing it. But even so, we still, if you were to still, as of today, which is early June, if you were to look up Quarantine Cabaret on YouTube, you would find this face on the front page. You'd have to scroll down a little ways to see it, but hey, we made the first page on YouTube if you were to look up Quarantine Cabaret. I'm really pleased to be doing it again. And keep in mind, this is not a special edition rebroadcast. This is how we are actually doing this from day one, right off the bat. So we are special from the beginning. Wouldn't you know it? Of course, the reason we are here of doing this again is because of our next performer, the organizer of these events. And she's known on stage for nailing the Irish accent, which made it no surprise that in 2015, she was cast as Mrs. Peru in the Lake Country Players production of the music man. So, now she's going to sing a song also from that show, but as Marion Peru. Here is my stage mom once again, Melissa Norton, singing Goodnight, My Someone.
Good night, my someone. Good night, my love. Sleep tight, my someone. Sleep tight, my love. A star is shining its brightest light. For good night, my someone. Good night. Sweet dreams be yours, dear, if dreams there be. Sweet dreams to carry you close to me. I wish they may, and I wish they might. Now good night, my someone, good night. True love may be whispered from heart to heart. When loved ones are parted, they say, but I must depend on a wish and a star. As long as my heart doesn't know who you are, sweet dreams be yours, dear, if dreams there be. Sweet dreams to carry you close to me. I wish they may, and I wish they might. Now good night, my someone, good night, good night, good night.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I noticed from the last show there was sort of an unspoken theme from all the performances. They were all performances of hope, and diligence, and resilience, that we'll all get through this pandemic together. And, well, clearly we still are, but this time we have another theme, it seems. It's called, This Time It's Personal for a Reason, after all. These are all performances that come straight from here. Yes, here. The human udder. Now anyway, let's keep on going. Let's show another performance that comes straight from here. Here is Lena Isett. Isett? I went to school with your brother and yet I still can't pronounce your name. I'm so sorry. In fact, I apologize in advance for everyone whose name I cannot pronounce. Anyway, here is Lena and she sings a wonderful song from the musical Hamilton, Burn.
Hello, my name is Madalena Isett. I will be playing Burn from the musical Hamilton. I am a sophomore at Horseheads High School. I'm sorry if you hear noises in the background. I have three dogs. I hope you enjoy. We saw your friend.
just let her arrive. She said, be careful with that one, love. He will do what it takes to survive. You and your words flooded my senses. Your sentences left me defenseless. You built me palaces out of paragraphs. You built cathedrals. I'm rereading the letters you wrote me. I'm searching and scanning for answers in every line, for some kind of sign of when you were mine. The world seemed to burn. Burn. You published the letter she wrote you. You told the whole world how you brought this girl into our bed. And clearing your name, you have ruined our lives. Do you know what Angelica said when she read what you'd done? She said, you married an Icarus. He has flown too close to the sun. You and your words obsessed with your legacy. Your sentences bordered on senseless, and you are paranoid in every paragraph how they perceive you. I'm erasing myself from the narrative. Let future historians wonder how Eliza reacted when you broke her heart. You have torn it all apart. I'm watching it. Watching it burn. The world has no right to my heart. The world has no place in our bed. They don't get to know what I said. I'm burning the memories, burning the letters that might have redeemed you. You forfeit your rights to my heart. You forfeit your place in our bed. You'll sleep in your office instead. I hope that you
She rocked our houses singing the classic song Jolene, and now she's back again with two more songs this show. Here's her first one, singing the classic song I'm Not That Girl from Wicked, is Michele Pariso Gingerich.
Heather, I do this for you.
Touch, eyes meet, sudden silence, sudden heat, hearts leap in a giddy whirl. He could be that boy, but I'm not that girl. Don't dream too far. Don't lose sight of who you are. Don't remember that rush of joy. He could be that boy. I'm not that girl. Every so often we long to steal to the land of what might have been, but that doesn't soften the ache we feel when reality sets back in. Blithe smile, light limb, she who's winsome, she wins him. Gold hair with a gentle curl, that's the girl he chose, and heaven knows I'm not that girl. Don't dream, don't start wishing only wounds the heart. I wasn't born for the rose and pearl. There's a girl I know, he loves her so. I'm not that girl.
You know, often I just like to sit back, relax, and enjoy the nice warm limelight of the metaphorical fire. But I also like to kick back and enjoy some classic TV. I wonder just what there is out there.
Hello?
Hello. Is this Mary?
Yeah. Who is this?
What's your favorite kind of food?
Salad. Yeah, I like salad. I'm a vegetarian.
Oh, yeah? Well, Mary, I don't think you like salad at all.
Well, of course I do. I just had some.
I think you're lying. I think you had a can of corned beef. In fact, I think you had two cans of corned beef.
Who is this?
I'm right behind you.
Right behind me?
From the makers of I Know What You Did Last Summer, I Still Know What You Did Last Summer, and I'm Not Quite Sure What You Did Last Summer, But I'm Going to Kill You Anyway, comes a new flavor of fear.
Hey guys, who wants dinner? I've got stovetop stuffing.
Jennifer Love Hewitt.
What are you waiting for? I've got lots of food! I'm gonna eat it all!
Edward Norton.
Heather! Get out of there! Get out of there now!
What?
Don't talk! Get out of there now!
What?
Reese Witherspoon. And one of those guys from Dawson's Creek or something.
I can't start the car! I can't start the car! Oh, wait. Oh, this is the key for the door. there we go.
I know what you had for supper.
You guys, I don't remember buying tuna.
I know what you had for supper. Coming soon to theaters nowhere.
You know, I swear, David has not aged a day. Well, at any rate, you know, I tend to look on these things And I wondered to myself...
You got mail.
Strange. Haven't heard that in a while. We just got an email. We just got an email. We just got an email. I wonder who it's from.
We're no strangers to love. You know the rules, and so do I. A full commitment's what I'm thinking of. You wouldn't get this from any other guy. I just wanna tell you how I'm feeling. Gotta make you understand. I'm never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna run around and desert you. Never gonna make you cry. Never gonna say goodbye. Never gonna tell a lie and hurt you.
Very funny, Allison Brennan. Pulling the oldest joke on the internet. Well, anyway, our next lovely act is one of the Love girls. Here is Daphne Love, and she has a rather darling performance of a classic song from a classic Broadway show, Tomorrow, from Annie. With another fan favorite of everyone's, the lovely Tessa Mullooly rocking the ukulele, singing a song that she likes to call Lana.
Thank you.
Change the words on, so hopefully it'll be all right. On a long and lonesome hallway, east of the living room, you can listen to the coffee pot dripping out a one-note tune. You can think about the outside like you did some months ago. But your thoughts will soon be wandering the way they always do when you're stuck in the house for hours and there's nothing much to do and you don't feel much like sitting. You just wish the virus was through. Here I am at home again. There I am, trying to be brave. Here I go, playing cards again. There I go, turn the page. I'm a Christian, on God's word I ride, but I'm wanted. Dead or alive, I'm a Christian. On God's word I ride, but I'm wanted, wanted, dead or alive. You know, Satan, yeah. Satan wants me dead, but my Lord Jesus wants me alive. I said to Satan, wants me dead, but my Lord Jesus wants me alive. I'm a Christian. On God's word I ride, but I'm wanted. Dead or alive. Dead or alive. Dead or alive. Thank you very much. I enjoyed that. I hope you did too.
I'm sure everyone's favorite moments of the last quarantine cabaret was when I kept getting interrupted by the gentleman known as Joe Edkin, who just so happens to be my mentor in theater. Well, I've secured this quarantine cabaret with the highest of highest VPNs to make sure there are no security threats. But that doesn't mean I'm not gonna let him perform on his own merits. So here is Joe Edkin with Jack Olcott as they perform a scene from the classic Broadway show Man of La Mancha.
This La Mancha, what's it like?
An empty place, a wide open space, a desert. To some, a wasteland.
Where apparently they grow lunatics.
Say rather, men of illusion.
Much the same. Why are you poets so fascinated with madmen?
I suppose it is because we have much in common.
You both turn your backs on life.
We both select from life that which pleases us.
A man must come to terms with life as it is.
Oh, my friend, I have lived nearly 50 years, and I have seen life as it is. Pain, misery, hunger, cruelty beyond belief. I have heard the singing from alley taverns and the moans from the bundles of filth in the street. I have been a soldier and seen my comrades fall in battle or die more slowly under the lash in Africa. I have held them in my arms in their final moments. These were men who saw life as it is, and yet they died despairing. No glory, no gallant last words, only their eyes open wide, whimpering the question, why? I do not think they asked why they were dying, but why they had lived at all. When life itself seems lunatic, who knows where madness lies? Perhaps to be too practical is madness. To surrender dreams, this may be madness. To seek treasure where there is only trash. Perhaps too much sanity is madness. And maddest of all, to see life as it is, rather than how it ought to be.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have yet another performance from Man of La Mancha. This time a song, sung by none other than the cool old man himself, Ken Corby.
Well, I was digging around my costume room for a little inspiration, and I came across this. This is the chess piece I wore when I was Don Quixote de la Mancha for Lake Country Players back in the 90s. An interesting backstory to this is that at that time I was clean shaven. There was like a 5-year period when I did that, and Jane Dom, bless her heart, had to build a beard every single performance, and she did an awesome job. Now I come equipped. So anyway, you would think I would want to sing The Impossible Dream, but you know what? That is an impossible dream because I don't know that I could reach the high notes anymore. However, there is a song in there that I do like that I remember part of, so I'll sing you the part I remember, and that'll fill a little time at least, if nothing else. And this is when little Lanzo Quijana, meek and mild, is overcome by the terrible things that he saw happening. And you know, in today's world, it's very topical. But Alonzo decided he would become a knight-errant and right all the wrongs in the world, and so he became Don Quixote de la Mancha. Hear me now, O thou bleak and unbearable world, thou art base and debauched as can be. Errant knight with his banners all bravely unfurled, will hurl down his gauntlet to thee. I am I, Don Quixote, the Lord of La Mancha. My destiny leads me, I'll go. and the wild winds of fortune will carry me onward to whithersoever they blow. Whithersoever they blow. Onward to glory I go.
Earlier in the show, you saw Tessa playing the ukulele and rocking out. Well, here we have another ukulele singer, Tim Kirkpatrick, singing what I remember as the New York State Lottery theme song a number of years ago. It played all the time on the radio on the school bus. What a day for a daydream.
I'm blowing the day to take a walk in the sun and fall on my face on somebody's new mowed lawn. I've been having a sweet dream. I've been dreaming since I woke up today. It started me in my sweet dream. 'Cause she's the one makes me feel this way. And even if time is passing me by a lot, I couldn't care less about the dues you say I've got. Tomorrow I'll pay the dues for dropping my load, a pie in the face for being a sleepy punto. A daydream will last you long into the night. Tomorrow at breakfast you may pick up your ears, or you may be daydreaming for a thousand years. What a day for a daydream, custom made for a daydreaming boy, and I'm lost in a daydream, dreaming about my bundle of joy.
Nice daydream.
And this here is my metaphorical pipe. Smoking's bad for you kids. Nothing like sitting and watching some old, good old-fashioned television on the old tablet. Oh, look. Someone just sent me a preview of Rick and Morty Season 10. Huh. I didn't know they got that far. Let's find out.
We've known each other for so long. Your heart's been aching, but you're too shy to say it. Inside we both know what's been going on. We know the game and we're gonna play it. And if you ask me how I'm feeling, don't tell me you're too blind to see. Never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you, never gonna make you cry, never gonna say goodbye, never gonna tell a lie and hurt you.
Oh, hi, Michele. Oh, bye, Michele. See you at your next act. Well, enough of this. I'm just gonna go for the old-fashioned version of television. These things called books. And feel free to go on to the next act, which is Christa Perez as she sings, Dream a Little Dream of Me.
it's Christa. Just here to sing a little bit of Mamas and Papas, Dream a Little Dream of Me. Stars shining right above you. Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dream of me. Say nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me close and tell me you'll miss me. While I'm alone and blue as can be, dream a little dream of me. Stars spreading, but I linger on, dear, still craving your kiss. I'm longing to linger till dawn, dear, just waiting for this. Sweet dreams till sunbeams find you. Sweet dreams that leave the worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever they be, dream a little dream of me. Ba da 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 da. I love you. I miss you. Singing social worker, time to say goodnight. Love you all. Hope to see you soon. Stay safe. Bye.
Well, I hope you will all allow me to be frank, because I'm not Frank. I'm Zach. Nice to meet you. But I figured I'd try my own little number. It's a classic, if you were either born in or grew up in the 90s. Foolish Games by Jewel.
You took your coat off, stood in the rain. You're always crazy like that. And I watched from my window, always felt like I was outside, looking in on you. You're always the mysterious one with dark eyes and careless hair. Questionably sensitive, but too cool to care. Stood in my doorway with nothing to say besides some comment on the weather. In case you fail to notice, in case you fail to see, this is my heart bleeding before you. This is me down on my knees. These foolish games are tearing me apart. Thoughtless words are breaking my heart. You're breaking my heart. You're always brilliant in the morning, smoking your cigarettes and talking over coffee. Your philosophies on art baroque you moved. You loved Mozart, and you'd speak of your loved ones. As I clumsily strummed my guitar, you excused me. Guess I've mistaken you for somebody else. somebody who gave a damn, somebody more like myself. And these foolish games are tearing me, you're tearing me, you're tearing me apart in your thoughtless words are breaking my heart. You're breaking my heart. You took your coat off in the rain. You're always crazy like that.
Thank you. And now for our next act. Here is Cynthia Louise reading a little piece she wrote called A Little Lost.
This is my recording for A Little Lost for Quarantine Cabaret, as read by Cynthia Louise. Here we go. A Little Lost. Once upon a time, on a blue and green planet, somewhere northeast or southwest of here, there lived a sheep. There was nothing particularly unusual about this little sheep, except that she lived on this blue and green planet. She was cared for by a little shepherdess. The sheep's name was Lumi, and what is particularly special about this little sheep was that she and the little shepherdess were about to have a big adventure. Lumi and her flock lived on a plain of green grass that grew long and waved in the breezes that danced across the plain. The grass was always green and the sun usually shone. The little shepherdess lived in a house made of sticks and mud and was covered in drawings of her little sheep. Next to the house was a little lean-to where her sheep lived. It was there that she sheared them and stored their wool and feed. The little shepherdess would sing to her sheep. Her voice would often echo across the grasses of the plain. Lululi. While all seemed wonderful, the little shepherdess was afraid of the dark, believing there were monsters that lived there, especially in the forest on the edge of where she lived. The trees were tall and clustered together. They looked like tall people. The little shepherdess never traveled into the forest, just to the stream that flowed by the edge of the trees. At night, she heard strange noises coming from the forest. Every evening, the little shepherdess, at a half an hour before sunset, would gather her little flock of sheep and herded them into the lean-to. She had five sheep in her flock. There was a big black sheep named Bob, the twins, Mackie and Mercer. There was Shiny, whose coat was quite shiny. And of course, there was little Lumi. On this particular day, at a half an hour before sunset, the little shepherdess went to gather her sheep. There was Bob and Mackie, Mercer and Shiny, but Lumi was nowhere to be seen. She called to her, and all the sheep bounded over to her, all except Lumi. Lumi was missing. Lumi, Lululi. She searched the green grasses of the plain, between the clusters of wildflowers, and even down by the stream at the edge of the forest. The light was growing dark, turning slowly from gold to orange. She continued to call out to Lumi, but the trees from the forest seemed to inch closer to her. Lululee. As the little shepherdess ran down to the forest's edge, the wind began to whip around her, and she jumped at any little noise. She watched the trees. They were waving a sort of strange hello to her. The little shepherdess began to cry as she called out for Lumi. Lululee. There was a bleating from behind her. Bob and Shiny had escaped the lean-to and were running out to her, bleating loudly. Me! Me! She cried harder. She ran to Bob and Shiny, wrapping her arms around them. Noises came from the trees, and the sky was beginning to turn a deep violet purple. The little shepherdess held on to her sheep tightly, singing, Lululee. She stood there, glancing back into the trees, searching for Lumi everywhere and anywhere. There was still no response. Bob and Shiny were bleating to the little shepherdess. Overhead, the stars began to poke through the daylight as nighttime crept closer. I guess we should go back home. The little shepherdess looked back at her house. The firelight spilled out from her doorway as she turned back to her house, with Bob and Shiny following her. I need to keep the fire going, Bob. Shiny, the monsters will come close. The wind blew harshly against the walls of her house, but first she had to attend to her sheep. She kept glancing down to the forest's edge, with the noises echoing back at her. Thunder rumbled in the distance. Rumble, 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 rumble. A draft blew through the little house, rustling the flames of the little shepherdess's fire. She sat there thinking about Lumi out in the night and the dark. I've never let any of my sheep out after sunset. They've never been out after sunset. The little shepherdess watched her doorway. The door was made up of a large piece of fabric and was blowing in the wind of the oncoming storm. It was cold, and it made her pull the deerskin blanket tightly around her shoulders. Boom went the thunder. Flash went the lightning. The little shepherdess stared out into the fire, and then at the doorway. She whispered a song she was always singing. When you are frightened, I'm here. Don't you worry. When I sing the monsters away. It was raining now. The little shepherdess sat behind her fire, watching her doorway as the storm raged on. A thought occurred to her. She never, never left her sheep out alone. So why was she doing it now? She threw off the blanket and, grabbing her cloak and staff, rushed out of the doorway. She peered into the night. The lightning flashed, flash, looming, illuminating the outside for a moment. Lululee, can you hear me? The little shepherdess sang out into the growing storm. It felt like her voice bounced right back at her as the words echoed across her cheeks. She stepped out into the rain and towards the forest edge, toward the deer path. It was glowing in the dim light of the storm. The rain pelted her cheeks as she trudged down the slope to the trees. The deer path was still illuminated. She called out to Lumi. It was hard to see with the rain coming down, hitting her in the face. She was afraid, but the little shepherdess did something that she had never done before. She stepped onto the deer path and passed the line of trees into the forest proper. What was that? The little shepherdess thought she saw eyes in the trees, glowing eyes that were watching her. She was afraid. These were the monsters from her nightmares. Branches grabbed at her cloak and hair, but her voice sang out. It felt like it wasn't going far through the rain, but she sang anyway. Lululi. Her foot caught a tree root and she stumbled forward. She couldn't see anything in the dark, but then the lightning streaked across the sky. The deer path was now just to her right, and she saw a row of stones lining the edge of the path. The lightning flashed, and the stones seemed to glow. Well, that helps. The little shepherdess stood on the deer path, but a snap of a twig made her jump. She thought there was a monster behind her. There was nothing when she turned around. The words of her song frozen on her lips at the moment. Nothing was behind her, just the darkness. Lululi. Felt like she had been walking forever. She did not know where she was and was crying again. It was hard to tell the rain mixed with tears as she cried. Oh, help me, please. The little shepherdess kept walking. She was able to see the little stones that edged the path, and that made her less afraid. She saw there were flowers growing between some of the little stones, and up ahead there was a grove of trees. It seemed to encircle the little shepherdess from out of nowhere, and the trees grew lighter in the middle of the clearing. There were snapdragons and buttercups all around. Lululi, sang the little shepherdess. She wasn't thinking of monsters right now. Help. The clearing grew brighter and the rain slowed. The wind was not blowing now. The little shepherdess saw that there was a wishing well standing in the center of the clearing. Its thatched roof partially collapsed. There were firebugs flying around the well's opening. She walked over to the wishing well, singing, Lululi, can you hear me? I am calling, looking for thee. The light exploded in the clearing, making it too bright to see. The little shepherdess closed her eyes. Everything was colored periwinkle, even with her eyes closed. The firebugs hummed lightly, and their light glowed as well. When the little shepherdess opened her eyes, she saw the wishing well. There was a muffled scraping from deep inside the well. The little shepherdess felt afraid. She thought there might be a monster in the well. Lululi, can you hear me? Suddenly, from deep in the well, there came a bleating. I am calling, looking for thee. She sang, rushing up to the edge of the well, still afraid to look. The firebugs provided the only light that the little shepherdess could see down into the well. When she looked down, she saw Lumi splashing around, bleating mercilessly. Me! Me! Her wool was soaked and glowed with a periwinkle light. When Lumi saw the little shepherdess, she began to bleat louder. Me! Me! The little shepherdess said, Oh, little one, little Lumi, I have found thee. Please do not be afraid. I am here. Lululi, I am calling for thee. The little shepherdess looked around the clearing. There was not much there but flowers. Nearby, there was a little birch tree. It looked like a mini sentinel watching over the wishing well. There was an old coil of rope hanging from its nearest branch, and a rusty bucket lying at its roots. This gave the little shepherdess an idea. She grabbed the bucket and the coil of rope. Tugging on the rope, she felt it was strong. Lumi was bleating loudly now, and the little shepherdess rushed back to stare into the well. Me! Me! She worked fast, tying the rope to the bucket's handle. The rope did not break. Gently, the little shepherdess lowered the bucket into the well and sang. Lu-lu-li. She hoped that the bucket was big enough. When there was a splash of water, she knew that the bucket had met the water. Lumi continued to cry out to the little shepherdess. Me! Me! The rain had stopped. Little one, Lu-lu-li, please help me. The little shepherdess pulled the rope across the space between the wishing well and the little birch tree. Her fingers were stiff from the cold rain, and she dropped the rope twice. She did not lose the rope, but the bucket still splashed in the well. Lumi bleated louder. Me! Me! Her fingers cramped as she tied the rope to the birch tree's outstretched branch. Back at the well, the little shepherdess looked down at Lumi. The little sheep looked up at her, bathed in the firebug's light. Lumi's eyes were wide with fear. Lu-lu-li, no need to fear. I will rescue you. The little shepherdess beckoned Lumi towards the bucket. Lu-lu-li, come to me. Climb into the bucket, Lumi. Lumi swam clumsily toward the bucket, struggling. She put her front hooves into the bucket, and the little shepherdess tugged gently on the rope. The bucket moved, and Lumi bleated loudly. Me! Me! Sorry, Lumi. Lumi wriggled into the bucket, but was only halfway in when the little shepherdess began to pull on the rope. The bucket rose slowly, Lumi panically bleeding as the bucket hit against the wishing well's sides. Slowly, the bucket rose as the little shepherdess pulled. Her arms hurt as she pulled on the rope and the bucket. The bucket tipped twice, and Lumi bleated in alarm. Me! Me! The little shepherdess was afraid, but she continued to pull on the rope and the bucket with Lumi halfway inside. Lu-lu-li, do not be afraid. The thunder rumbled in the distance, but the rain did not fall. Instead, the silvery moon shined over the clearing. It revealed Lumi's wool glowing periwinkle. A chorus of peepers began to sing, and the bucket reached the top of the well. The little shepherdess rushed to grab the bucket and Lumi. She grabbed Lumi, but the bucket tumbled back into the well and there was a splash as it hit the water. The little shepherdess hugged Lumi. A moment later, she put Lumi on the grass and the little sheep began munching hungrily at the grass around the wishing well. The wind picked up, but it did not rain. Lumi began to dance in the clearing, with the peepers' songs growing louder. The little shepherdess began to sing. As long as I am me, Lu-lu-li, nothing can scare me. Lumi stopped to look at the little shepherdess. Let's go home, Lumi. Upon the path, the little shepherdess walked. For the first time, she walked through the forest, no longer afraid. The monsters in the trees did not scare her. She only saw trees on either side of the deer path. The peepers sang and the firebugs hummed, and Lumi danced in the moonlight. The end.
And now here's the other half of the adorable love sister duo. Here's my sister from another mister, Wendy Love, singing How Far I'll Go.
staring at the edge of the water long as I can remember, never really knowing why. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water no matter how hard I try. Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know where I cannot go, where I long to be. See the line where the sky meets the sea, it calls me, and no one knows how far it goes. If the wind in my sail on the sea stays behind me, one day I'll know. If I go, there's just no telling how far I'll go. I know everybody on this island seems so happy on this island. Everything is by design. I know everybody on this island has a role on this island, so maybe I can roll with mine. I can lead with pride, I can make us strong, I'll be satisfied if I play along. But the voice inside sings a different song. What is wrong with me? See the light as it shines on the sea, it's blinding, but no one knows how deep it goes. And it seems like it's calling out to me, so come find me and let me know what's beyond that line. Will I cross that line? See the line where the sky meets the sea, it calls me, and no one knows how far it goes. If the wind in my sail on the sea stays behind me, one day I'll know how far I'll go.
Oh, I'm sorry. There are some new video games I just wanted to try out, and, here's an interesting new one.
Hello, I'm a doctor. In today's world of corporate-driven healthcare, profits take precedence over patient care. Doctors, such as myself, are caught between the massive conglomerates that are focused on the dividends of the shareholders and the insurance companies that want to minimize the payouts to the healthcare providers. When you add into this the years and years of crippling student loan debt, it is no wonder that many doctors, like me, are forced to take secondary jobs. Lucky for me, I do not have a good reputation to protect, so I don't even have to think twice about selling my professional credentials to the highest bidders to endorse some truly dubious claims. Are you listening, Mr. President? I know you're just itching to replace Anthony Fauci. Well, while I'm waiting for the president to call, I'm here today on behalf of the United Mothers Appeal, an organization that is paying me a substantial sum of money to convince you that the homespun advice of your mother still has value in today's world, if only you just paid attention to her. How often do you recall your mother whinging about this?
Eat your kale, dear. Don't make that face. What if it freezes that way?
What a load of twiddle twaddle, is probably what you're saying to yourself as a full-grown adult. Although if you are using such phrases as twiddle twaddle, you might need professional help. In that case, I recommend you get a hold of me via the United Mothers Appeal, and make sure you have a large cash payment on hand when you do. Now, where was I? Oh yes, you might ask yourself, what in the world could I possibly encounter that would cause my face to freeze in an expression of abject horror? As a medical professional, I have decided to test the United Mothers Appeal's thesis to find out if their dire warning has a practical application in today's hurly-burly world. Watch as I expose several of my deadbeat patients to one of the most horrific creatures that I could find within these United States to determine if their faces would get frozen in the most ghastly expressions possible when confronted by sheer ineptitude and or malevolence. Or both.
I would build a great wall, and nobody builds walls better than me, believe me. And I'll build them very inexpensively. I will build a great, great wall on our southern border, and I will have Mexico pay for that wall.
Yeah.
Mark my words.
Yeah. He claimed TV footage and photos of his inauguration day made the crowds look smaller than they were, adding that it looked like 1.5 million people were present.
And it showed an empty field. And it said we drew 250,000 people.
It looked, honestly, it looked like 1.5 million people, whatever it was. But it went all the way back to the Washington Monument. Is that, as you know, I have a running war with the media. They are among the most dishonest human beings on earth.
I do think there's blame, yes. I think there's blame on both sides. You look at both sides. I think there's blame on both sides, and I have no doubt about it, and you don't have any doubt about it either. But you also had people that were very fine people on both sides. You had people in that group, excuse me, I saw the same pictures as you did. You had people in that group that were there to protest the taking down of, to them, a very, very important statue and the renaming of a park from Robert E. Lee to another name. If you have a windmill anywhere near your house, congratulations. Your house just went down 75% in value. And they say the noise causes cancer. You tell me that one, okay? You know, the thing makes it so... And, of course, it's like a graveyard for birds.
Did you tell the Ukrainian leader that they would have the aid only if they investigated Joe Biden and his family?
No, I didn't. I hope you get to see the call, because your question, you will see, I did not ask for, I did not make a statement that you have to do this or I'm not going to give you aid. I wouldn't do that.
Sir, you can authorize release the transcript. Will you do that,
I can
sir?
Do it very easily, but I'd rather not do it from the standpoint of all of the other conversations I have. I may do it because it was a very innocent call. I think, importantly, anybody right now and yesterday, anybody that needs a test gets a test. They're there. They have the tests. And the tests are beautiful. So if you're testing 14 million people, you're going to find many more cases. Many of these people aren't very sick, but they still go down as a case. So if we were testing 1 million people instead of 14 million people, we would have far fewer cases. Right? So I view it as a badge of honor. Really, it's a badge of honor. It's a great tribute to the testing and all of the work that a lot of professionals have done.
I'll be dogged. I mean, I've had patients who gasp when I present them with my bill, but their faces normally go back to normal. But these poor, pathetic fools? When faced with something even more distressing than a medical bill without insurance? I mean, just look at those faces! Could it be that Mom was right all along?
So listen to your mama. You don't want me to come over there.
Well, that wasn't a very fun video game. I kept dying 3 times in that skit. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this whole quarantine cabaret number 2 thing's really making me hungry, so I'm gonna go grab a roast beef sandwich. You guys can watch this next performance. It's another song that was performed last time, Hallelujah. This time it's by David Holloway and Dash Dunn, so enjoy!
Thank you.
Quarantine cabaret like a fine panini dinner. Lit by lamplight, nonetheless. Oh, look, we've even got some fine entertainment right here. Well, let's see what's on, shall we?
You from worrying.
But it doesn't matter now, now that you're here.
Yes. What matters now is that I am now here.
And that we are together at last.
Oh, when were we last together?
It's been too long since the last time.
Yes, it's been too long a time since the last one.
But here you are.
Yes, I am here, and so are you.
And nothing will take us apart!
I'm here to take you apart.
I'll hear nothing of it.
You! It's you! I never loved you.
Then why, when you left me, did you leave me this letter that says I love you?
Love? Why did you leave him that letter?
That letter I left was a love letter for you.
So you didn't leave it for me?
No, I didn't mean to leave it there.
I knew you loved me.
I knew you'd leave me.
Come live with me, my love.
If you love him, I will not let you live.
Leave me with my love, you loser.
Alas, I will not lose, nor will I leave, until I have the love that left me the letter, or I will not let you lovers live.
At last, my lover, we can live together.
Yes, together, my love, we can leave the Yukon forever.
Together.
My liver.
Forever.
Very nice, 90s David Scott. Very nice. Now, continuing on with our acts, here is everyone's favorite Sarah Love and her two little adorable helpers as she sings, "I Don't Want to Live on the Moon." Sorry about that, folks. I had just decided to go out for a little jog out there, you know. Seems that I've taken 999 steps today, according to the Fitbit I'm not wearing. I just felt that, you know, it's such a gorgeous day out. It fills my heart with happiness and joy and sunshine. It's kind of like this next clip from a melodrama at the old Havana Courthouse Theater, about a character singing about his happiness in the ray of sunshine.
the paint and the blues, beautiful hues, colored with gold and gold rose, like the clown trying to draw on my woes. Though things may not look bright, they'll all turn out all right if I keep painting the clouds with sunshine.
Prospector. 3 weeks, count them. 3 weeks I've had to deal with his insidiousness. What's the matter? Once he breaks through to the bank vaults, I'll be rich, rich, rich. Though things may not look bright, they'll all turn out all right if I keep painting the clouds with the sunshine. When I hold back a tear to make a smile appear,
is that we've had some new faces joining us this time around. And here's one of them. Here is Johnny Coon singing, Where Do You Start?
Hi, guys. Okay, we're going to try this. This is take 5. I have never done this before, and this looks queer. Sorry. I've been out in the yard. I've been... I didn't dress for the occasion. I apologize. Anyway, this is weird. I have never, ever recorded myself singing. I don't even sing in my house, really. Singing's for the car, and I'm not about to video it as I drive. Anyway, so yeah, it's really weird. I'm not used to not singing in front of people. I'm not used to, I miss my microphone. I have a very nice vintage microphone that I love. Good sound, it's sure quality. Anyway, and I've never sung to anybody in my underwear, so you're going to be the first. Anyway, it's true, but don't picture it. Anyway, the song that I'm about to do, actually, I'm going to take you over with me because you're not going to see how messy my kitchen is. And I have no excuse either. We've had all this time. Beautiful weather we've been having. But my house is full of plants right now because tonight's supposed to be cold. Anyway, let's get on with it. I need more wine. How do you separate the present from the past? How do you deal with all the things you thought would last? That didn't last. With bits of memory scattered here and there, I look around and don't know where to start. Which books are yours? Which tapes and dreams belong to you and which are mine? Our lives are tangled like the branches of a vine that intertwine. So many habits that we'll have to break, and yesterdays we'll have to take apart. Someday I'll hear a song or something in the air again to take me by surprise, and you'll be there again. Moment in what might have been. Where do you start? Do you allow yourself a little time to cry? Or do you close your eyes and kiss it all goodbye? I guess you try. And though I don't know where and I don't know when I'll find myself in love again, I promise there will always be a little place inside of me, a tiny part here in my heart that stays in love with you. Though I don't know where and I don't know when I'll find myself in love again, I promise there will always be a little place no one will see, a tiny part here in my heart that stays in love with you. Sorry, guys, I don't know many Broadway songs. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you stay safe. And I hope you stay well. I love you guys and I miss you. Shut up! I didn't pay the orchestra. See you soon, I hope. Bye.
Sorry, forgot I had this on. Lovingly custom made mask from one of my dearest friends, Melissa Newfer, who just so happens to be our next performer, along with Mr. Alex Adams. They're singing a popular song from a popular musical that is also very popular here at the Quarantine Cabaret. Last time we've had a performer singing Somewhere That's Green, and now here these two are singing Suddenly Seymour.
Lift up your head, wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly, Seymour, standing beside you. You don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend. Suddenly, Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding. Seymour's your
nobody friend. Ever treated me kindly. Daddy left early, Mama was poor. I need a man and I'd follow him blindly. He'd snap his fingers, me, I'd say sure. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside me. He don't give me don't condescend. Suddenly Seymour is here to provide me sweet understanding. Seymour's my friend.
Tell me the sweet will last till forever. Tell me the bad times of the mosh clean away.
Please understand that it's still strange and frightening. Losers like I've been, it's so hard to say. Suddenly Seymour,
keep purified me.
Suddenly Seymour, show me again. Learn how to be.
Pandemic, a lot of weird things tend to happen. Like this package I got that's apparently addressed to me. It's been backlogged for a year, because apparently it was sent to the wrong address. I wonder who could have sent this to me. I mean, I don't remember ordering anything last year. I wonder who then?
Hey, Joey.
Oh, hey. What's that pat for? Oh, man. What happened to you?
Who?
You?
Yes. Who?
I'm asking, what happened to you?
Who? You who? No, I don't drink that crap. What is this? Who? This. Who is this? Yes, this is who. Living golem doll from hell. What? What is this, made out of Play-Doh? Doubt it. But I found it in the most unlikely of places.
Enough for me.
And then I looked it up in the book and I did the ritual that it described.
You know, I think I may believe you more if this came out of a Cracker Jack box.
No, Joey, you don't understand. This thing is evil. He who disturbs who will be disturbed by who.
Rituals, huh?
Joey, what are you doing?
Quarters.
Joey, why are you writing this down? Sugar. Don't write this down.
You know, rituals, I think I'll be the judge of that.
No, Joey, stop. Joey, please don't. No, Joey, come back. No, Joey, stop, please.
Oh, no.
All right, a pinch of flour. Two quarters evenly aligned. And now for the magic curse words. Lurbity smooths. Oh, the left quarter is supposed to be 3 centimeters upright. See, I knew he was full of shit. Kidding me. You bastard son of Bert and Ernie! I'm gonna kill you! Lucky for you, I took 6 years of typo.
I now know to never talk before I fight again.
Finish him.
But how?
Too late.
What now, Gumby? Pillow fight! Wait, what are you doing? What are you doing? No, no, please, no, no! No! That's it. I'm gonna kill you!
Wait.
Come back here!
I don't look like purple either. It's not my favorite color!
Get back here!
This is where I will draw I will draw my line. Burning my cathedrals, 'cause I don't pray anymore. Look at all these people, tragic little people. They're smiling and they don't know what for. But then I know what's wrong. God, you've complicated everything. I know you're gone, gone, gone. This is where I will blur my line. I will blur my line. Yeah! My house is haunted, dark and deserted. They're made of my secrets and shame. Baby, I want this, but I know I'm not worth it. I can't even sell you my name. But then I know what's wrong. God, you've complicated everything. I know you're wrong, God. You took it all away from me. I know you're gone, gone, gone. This is where I will cross my line. I am crossing my line.
Man, it's a wonder what technology can do these days. It's even got to the point where our tablets have a sense of humor. Hey Alexa, knock knock.
Okay, here we go. Knock knock.
Who's there?
Matthew.
Matthew who?
We've known each other for so long. Your heart's been aching, but you're too shy to say it. Inside, we both know what's been going on. We know the game and we're gonna play it. I just wanna tell you how I'm feeling. Gotta make you understand. Never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna run around and desert you. Never gonna make you cry. Never gonna say goodbye. Never gonna tell a lie and hurt you. Never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna run around and desert you. Never gonna make you cry. Never gonna say goodbye. Never gonna tell a lie and hurt you.
So done with technology, I tell you what. Well, how could I? I mean, technology's what's keeping us all together right now, isn't it? even allows us to duet with each other remotely, just like this next performance. Singing a lovely duet with each other for the song I Knew Him So Well from Chess, we have Amanda Smith and Adriana Fodi Giancalli. Here in Boston, the summers may be hot, but this next performance will be even hotter. Here is an artist who has written songs for companies such as Doritos, and even with all the craziness going on in the world right now, including the metropolis you see behind me, he knows how to put the power to the metal in spoken word poetry. So here he is performing a piece he wrote himself called Catch the Moon. Please put your hands together for Walt Way.
My boy called me for advice after he lost someone he considered to be his better half. It was medieval the way uncertainty tore the heart from the sleeve of his jean jacket and buried it deep into Nate Robinson's wingspan. I couldn't, with an honest heart, say, I know what you're going through. I never lost a best friend. I have lost a parent, and he says, that's why I called you. As he looks upon the face of his child has that look when you're driving through the middle of nowhere and all you can recognize is tree, Waffle House, lost. He told me the news was harder to break than the amethyst molded frame mirror she used to do her makeup in. He and that mirror misses her palette every morning before work. Their son took it hard. My friend didn't know what to do. He bought him everything from new video games to new shoes. He took him to his favorite places to eat, even though he'll just stare at the plate as if he was waiting for his mother to come up and cut those chicken tenders into more manageable pieces. He let his ice cream drip from the parlor back home as if this sweet boy was leaving a trail for Hansel and Gretel. His father asks, isn't that your favorite? The son says, yes. He said, why aren't you eating it? The son says, maybe mommy's lost. She knows I like this kind of ice cream. Maybe she'll see it on the ground and come home. But dad says, son, mommy isn't coming home. She lives up there now as he points to the sky. The son broke down like the Legos he kept next to his toy chest as he sprinted to his bedroom, and now we're here. His dad is on my line, spilling apologies over the phone as if he knocked over a cup with memories of my father. I told him, look, you're like a brother to me. In any black home, that means we're family now. You called about my nephew. Gifts are nice, but have you talked to him? I know we come from the man up era. We taught that we couldn't be sad. No. We turned tears into fists, and we fought anything that made us feel like less of a man that we were told that we needed to be. And right now, my nephew needs a lover, not a fighter. He called me later that night. He said he hugged his son and said, I miss her too. I try to be strong, but I cry sometimes. And that's okay. Just know that I'm here for you. His son grabs his arm, pulls him out the house into the backyard. He points and says, Daddy, I want that. He says, Mommy is in the sky. She lives on the moon now because the sun is too hot. He said, I'm sorry, son. The moon is quite far, and it's always moving. And my boy thought he snapped his son hard in two. His son said, I know how we're going to get there. My boy told me they spent hours building a rocket ship out of Legos. They sat it on a nightstand next to the picture of his mother. His son said, Daddy, one day, I'm going to catch the moon. And when I do, I'm going to bring mommy back home.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, you've seen him all over the stage and all over your television screens. And you've even seen him pop up a few times in this cabaret. Well, he's so multi-talented, he decided to cloak himself into four individuals to take on four certain personas for this next song. Here he is, the ever multi-talented David A. Scott Jr.
That boy took my love. Someday, but this boy wants you back again. That boy isn't good for you, though he may want you too. This boy wants you back again.
I was standing by my window on a cold and cloudy day when I saw a hearse come rolling out to carry the loved ones away. Will this circle be unbroken?
By and by, Lord, by and by, there's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. So I told the undertaker, please drive slow. For those loved ones that you're carrying, oh, I hate to see them go. Will the circle be unbroken? By, Lord, by. There's a better home awaiting in the sky.
I will follow close behind them, try to hold up and bring, but I could not hold my sorrow when they lay there in the grave. Will this circle be unbroken?
Bye-bye, Lord,
bye-bye, and bye.
There's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Oh, will this circle be unbroken? Bye-bye.
Oh,
each and every one of you.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you all so much. And thank you all for participating and for attending this broadcast of the Quarantine Cabaret Strikes Back. This time, it's personal. I think now that we've reached our finale, a few shout-outs are in place. So thanks once again to Melissa Norton for organizing all this. Thanks to Joe Edkin for compiling that lovely finale. Thanks to Charles Thomas for leading us in that finale. Thanks to David A. Scott Jr. for that lovely logo you saw in the beginning. And thanks to everyone who participated in not just the finale, but the entire cabaret again. It was nice to see some returning faces and some new faces. So, I'm sure many of you are wondering, are we going to have a third cabaret at some point this summer? Well, I can say for sure that since there's a second, there's usually always a third in place. So, in that event, I think you all remember we all democratically chose our title for this cabaret. Well, this time around we decided to go one step further and choose it the way they chose the president. By which I mean a bunch of old white guys in a fake college. So, drum roll please as I announce our next cabaret title. Come on, open. And our title is Return of the Quarantine Cabaret 3D. It's going to be presented in the third dimension, so be sure to bring your 3D glasses. Anyway, so that's it. Thank you all so much for joining us. Thank you for participating. And I hope everyone stays safe. Times have gotten even crazier since we were last with each other. But keep on the good fight, fight for what's right, and fight the power. Once again, from Boston, Massachusetts, I am Zach Swasta. Stay safe, and God bless you.
Okay, well, this has been the Quarantine Cabaret Strikes Back. This time it's personal. Good night, everyone, and see you next cabaret. I've got to get a new job.